All right, what up, too? Coming at you. Getting some work done on the Chevelle. Basically, I was today just trying to get the gap from the door to the quarter lined up. And I got it way better than what it was when dude put the other quarters on. So I'm real confident that the body didn't sag. Everything is fitting how it should fit. So I don't know if y'all remember the last quarters that was on here prior to, and it's still not lined up A1. I still got some other stuff that I need to get done, but I did some research, and it basically I showed that I found that it's about 3/16 of an inch that you'll want for a gap. Right here is 3/16. So this right here, actually up here, I'm sorry, where the scrape is around 3/16. So that's about kind of where you'll want it to be. Now I understand because I have this is a repop quarter. I know it ain't gonna fit 100% A1. So you can see it gets big, it gets small as it go down, then it opens up again. Part of the reason why this is opened up is because this has a little bit more concave than the original door. So when they do the stamping and all that, it's not 100% A1. But the gap, I mean, goodness gracious, is good for what it is. And I still got some tweaking to do, as you see at the bottom of the door. I got to pull a door out a little bit and line it up that way. And I didn't necessarily get the fender lined up 100% A1, but as you can see, I'm putting a little work in, getting them all put together. This thing will be, I'm hoping to have this all done by the end of the summer. I still got some more work that I got to get done yet on the firewall. Got to do a lot of sanding on that. And then, obviously, I got to get this side done, but I want to get the other side done first. Now, I did order some of my parts, so Christmas time, well, I ordered all of the parts, so Christmas time should be coming pretty soon. I'll be getting a new inner and outers assembly. I'll be getting that back filler piece, the rear brace. All that stuff will be coming as soon as OPG get off their lazy butt and send it. But, yeah, I'm putting that work in. I also did some measurements of the wheel houses that are in here. Now, I know he jacked them up, but I just wanted to get an idea of how much rim I can get up under there, because I'm going to probably order my outer and inner tubs or hoops for those HRE, 22-inch HRE rims. And I want to go as big as I possibly can, preferably. I don't want to have to do any notching of the frame and widening the tubs, but so before I put it all in, I'm gonna kind of get an idea of how big I want to go. I want to be able to throw a 335 tire under there, so you're looking anywhere between 12 and 13 inches. 11 and a half to 12 and a half inches, which will be 12 and a half to 13 and a half when you add the lip to lip. So inside will be, the max will be like 12 and a half. We'll see how that works out. I'm gonna order those outer and inners, and I'm gonna put one of the rims together just to get an idea of whether or not I do need to tub it a little bit and notch the frame. But I'll probably order those either this week or next week, and hopefully my other parts will be here by then. But like I said, too, just stay tuned. If you like the videos, hit the like button. If you hate the videos, go ahead and hate and hit the dislike button. And if you have any advice for me, just go ahead and leave a comment and give me some advice, because this is my first time of me diving into something this deep as far as body work is concerned and restructuring and all that stuff. So I'll holler at you too. One.